See if I did this thing. Okay, so I'm ready to put my tubing onto the rail. This is going to be my new one. You may have noticed on Jerome's that, and on standard Biesemeyer's, the tubing sticks out to the left of the angle iron, you know, 4 to 6 inches, just depending. So that just gives you the ability to move the T-square farther out for cutting the left of the blade. And of course, it's going to overhang the right more, generally about, you know, 10 to 12 inches. Now, since I have a sliding table on my table saw that I've made, I need to have my tubing flush with the edge of the angle iron. So you're going to see I'm just going to align them together. Now, the way I'm going to do this is I'm going to use these are handles from foam brushes that I save, and I just use them in here as spacers. So when I put this in here, I'm making sure that I've got that standoff pulling exactly right. Otherwise, if I have it down in here where the radius is, see, it's hard to make it pull just right because it's trying to that radius down here is interfering with it. So I just use these as just little spacers. It doesn't matter what you use, just some shim to hold it up. So when I pull this up here, so I'm going to pull it down and pull it here in two spaces, you know, two clamps at each end, and then I'm ready to just flip it up and touch my touch the bottom of the tubing with the drill bit. And like I said, I like to use this drill bit method versus a transfer punch, just so I don't have to do a whole lot of banging while I have this connected. So let me get at it. I'm gonna just put the tubing up here. And again, I'm gonna, you know, you want to make sure that you have your orientation just right. So here's my weld bead right here, and so I have that to where it's not going to interfere with where my screw holes are going to be. So let me just get busy. If I can find my other two dowels. Well, fortunately, got a whole drawer full of them. There they are on the ground. So like I said, you can use plywood or whatever, or wood, but like I said, plywood is never exactly 3/4, so you need to perhaps rip the plywood the other way to where you get a minimum of 3/4. That's what you need for the angle iron of the Very Super Cool Tools fence to have plenty of free movement so you can take it on and off really easily without any interference whatsoever. So there, it's nice and flush, and I'll just put these clamps on here. Gotta love the Bessie Rapid Action clamps. Any kind of clamp that you had would work. And you don't want to put your clamp where it's going to interfere with your screw hole. Okay, so that looks good, and I was just going to do a test. Yeah, well, that's pretty tight. Yeah, maybe I'm going to move this down just a little bit here. That's not moving. That's not moving. Maybe ratchet it down one more time. Okay, now I can just flip this up on its back. And and now I have access to just touch my drill with the sorry for not having that ready. With the number 7. So this is the number 7 that I drilled this out with first. So you don't want to open this hole up until you've used this as your locator. So all I'm doing is just touching in there. I don't have to drill all the way through. Should have safety glasses on while I'm drilling. Sorry about that. Good enough right there. So now I can roll it back down. And I've got perfect dimpled marks exactly in line with the way it's going to be assembled. So now I'll take this over to the drill press and drill these out. I had to make a little adjustment on my drill press. That was not fully supported. So earlier you may have seen me kind of struggling with that tipping. Now I've got this thing just rock solid. No matter how I push this across there, it's just perfect. So now I want to drill these out with number 7. I'm going to put the number 7 in, drill these out with the number 7, and then I'll change over to the 5/16, and I'll drill the angle iron out to 5/16 because that's what the little bit oversized quarter 20, so it'll have just a little bit of slop for alignment. The reason I like to do this is because now the same drill bit has the exact same, it finds the exact same profile as this. You know, you can't be sure that it's going to be identical with a transfer punch. It's just going to leave you a mark. And it was really nice cleaning this metal up so well because I'm barely getting any grime on my hands working this now. Needed to be done anyway to do a really pro paint job on it. If you were going to get it powder coated, you wouldn't mess with it because the powder coater would sandblast it for you, and so you wouldn't have to bother. But I'm painting mine myself. But like I also said, you could brighten this up like this and you could put Rust-Oleum clear enamel on this, call it good. So you wouldn't even need to paint it. If this was inside a shop, it'd be fine. Just go ahead and drill these out to 5/16 while I have this set up here and the camera's running.